We're here for the post-game show of the Los Angeles Rams. They have beaten the Cleveland Browns 23-17, playing at home on a Thursday night. We're opening up opening statements to Coach Geronimo. Good win, man. We really had a good time tonight, man. We had a game plan. We stuck to it. This was not our normal game plan. This is not how we would normally play. But when we saw what the Cleveland Browns were presenting us, from their scheme on offense and their scheme on defense and who they have, more importantly, on defense, we felt like we had to play a certain way. And that's the way it works, man. That's the way it works. We came out and ran the ball consistently. We didn't need lots of yards, but we needed to control the clock and be able to ground and pound, as they say. And then on defense, we came out with a good plan and played a lot of coverage and mixed our coverages up pretty well. Tried to make them look similar pre-snap and make Baker Mayfield have to make reads post-snap. And we came away with a good number of interceptions today, 5 interceptions. Could have had more, but we've had some penalties that almost got the Browns back into the game late in the game. So we're open up to questions, and then we're going to watch a little bit of film, something a little bit different we're due today. First question, Porter Apple. Hey, Coach, there's a lot of people in the media very curious about Cam Akers getting 29 rushing attempts and Jimmy G only with 5 passing attempts. I'm not sure if he got sacked. He might have had more. But, yeah, let's talk about that a little bit. Yeah, I think when you look at the way the game had to be won, we needed to control the ground, and that's what we did. Jimmy G still did make some really good throws in some situations that moved the sticks and played off the running game, play actions, RPOs. He didn't make any mistakes, and that's what we wanted. We were hoping to make the Browns offense make mistakes tonight, and I think that's what we did. Reporter Bacon, you're up. Coach, very, very interesting way you approached this game. There are a lot of people out there that may call this a non-sim version of your game. Let me just stop you right there, okay? Sim and semi-sim is the word that's been coming up a lot. And to be honest with you, we don't care. It's not that we're trying to get wins, but our approach is not going to look like a cookie-cutter approach every single week. We have different game plans for different people and different teams. And us coming out today and being a heavy run team is unlike maybe what we'd do next week or the week after. We just have to do what's appropriate for the team that we're playing. That team has a million superstars on defense, especially at the defensive back position. And our team is not on that level to compete with them. So one day, if we ever do get to that level and we have enough superstars to compete with them, then maybe, just maybe, we will actually, you know, do what we're supposed to do and not do what we're supposed to do, come up with a more balanced game. But we played a game to win, and we did. All right, what we'll do here is actually just go look at a little bit of film. I don't have any plays pulled up per se, but I think as we continue through the rest of the questions, we'll let some film be in the background. Hopefully it's not too loud. But, you know, this was a game, like I had said, man, that, you know, our defense is pretty damn good. We have a lot of good players on defense. And we wanted to come out and just really make Baker Mayfield's life hard. And we felt the best way to do that was to come out with a handful of plays that looked the same pre-snap and run through them in that series and make him just have to make the reads and make him have to make the throws. It was pretty obvious that Baker is trying to throw the ball a lot more this year than in past year seasons from what I've seen statistically. I'm not sure if there's a motivation behind it. I'm not sure if Vyrix has a plan for him or his receivers. But watching this game and noticing some of the stat lines from other games, he's become a very pass-happy team. So we welcomed that challenge, and we kind of tried to set up an environment that made him feel like pass was there for him, but really not. And the turnovers today, the 6 turnovers today, the 5 interceptions, that was important to us, and we did a good job at that. We know Rodgers can run the ball, and if anybody was to ever meet him in the playoffs, I'm sure that's what you're going to get, is a heavy, heavy run game. But it was pretty obvious that he's going away from his game plan a little bit. So that's how we matriculated the ball down the field on offense to set up our defense, let our defense play, and it worked out pretty well for us. Any other questions? Reporter Charlie. Coach, do you feel like there's anything that we should know about any other teams in the league? We haven't really heard from you the last post game you went around, and what's going on. I think every team is different, and that's the way that, you know, I'm going to approach this season. And we're going to prepare for our next game against the 49ers next and see what they do and what their approach is, and we might change up our whole game. I know last week we played the Seattle Seahawks, and we really used a quick passing game throughout most of the game because we know he uses the D-line. And because he uses the D-line, you know, you can't hold the ball back there. You can't stand back there and wait for deep routes to develop. So we threw a little bit more quick game, and that was really important for us. So, you know, next week it might be a different approach, and we just go from there. And we always said we wanted to be a run-first team. That's what we built our team to be this year. So that shouldn't be a surprise than what I did today, and try to run the ball a good amount. 30 runs is a lot, but like I had said, man, we're going to do what we got to do, you know, and that's how we're going to approach the season. As we look at the film, this film is up to watch, man. All these plays are there. You know, we had a plan of attack for different formations, different, you know, but we tried to make them look similar. We tried to make things look kind of like lull him to sleep, you know, like if you give him a cover two look, you run cover two for a little bit and then you switch it up later on as he gets closer to the red zone or something like that, you know. But I don't think what we did was really special because I think he's throwing about 30-something picks in a year in about five games. So it's not that we are doing anything more special than what other defenses have done, but we wanted to make sure we ensure that the game plan came out this way and the game looked like what it did. Any other reporters around? Reporter David, you're up. Hey, yeah, first time asking a question. What happened at the end of the game? It looked like it was really getting close towards the end. Yeah, we kept our game plan the way we wanted to, and we did what we had to do. It looks like he turned on big hit, aggressive tackles, because everybody on his defense was just lighting me up. I put on conservative on my running backs so that they can actually, hold on to the ball. And we were giving them the ball, and, you know, they had to hold on or else we were going to get our ass, you know, beat and probably fumble. And we ran a screen towards the end of the game, and that would have been a first down pretty much to seal the game. Came up, we should have probably just slid on the ground, but instead we made sure we got that first down, and we got hit, fumble. There would have been a touchdown return, but I think there was a penalty on that play. So he got the ball back, though. We were in field goal range to make us go up by more than two touchdowns. And then towards the end of the game, we had a roughing on Aaron Donald. We had a couple interceptions that were taken away. One was taken away for sure because of illegal contact, you know. So we could have had more interceptions towards the end, but it looks like, you know, the game was really in favor of him towards the end, but we just kept to our game plan and kept doing what we were doing, and it worked out for us at the end of the day. So that's about it, man. I just, you know, game's in the background of this video. You can just watch some of this stuff. The video is up if you have any curiosity of what happened in this game. We'll hopefully take this momentum, take our first place lead in the division, and keep on working our ass off and keep on keeping it fresh. All right. I will talk to you guys later. All right. Peace.